afternoon session. We have two talks of art, and they are the pieces of bread. In the middle, there's a talk on chemistry. So this is a wonderful session for you. The first two talks are sort of connected with each other since they relate to the same project. And so our first speaker will be Emma Campbell, who will be talking about the art of portrait miniatures. And I'll just kind of give you a preview that there's a science component that follows on that that's very much connected to it. So we'll turn the time over to Emma.
Portrait miniatures are a centuries-old version of profile pictures or relationship statuses on social media. These intimate little paintings give modern scholars insight into the artistic trends of several centuries and enlighten historians about the private lives of the subjects of the pieces. Although small in size, portrait miniatures possess a wealth of knowledge. The research presented here comes from a two-year interdisciplinary project. I was brought onto the project in the fall of 2013. And since then, I've worked closely with the miniatures, creating a database of all of the pieces and working intimately with the European miniatures in the Juniata College Museum of Art's collection. Through the art historical research done by Dr. Jennifer Streb and myself, and the scientific analysis completed with Dr. Richard Hark and Kate Passanante, who will speak after me, the research will be presented in the upcoming autumn 2015 show in the Juniata College Museum of Art titled The Art and Science of Portrait Miniatures. Beginning in the court of Henry VIII in the mid-16th century, miniatures became a very popular form of portraiture and remained so until the invention of photography. The English monarchy had a very close relationship with portrait miniatures. Henry VIII kept his close to him as an extension of his private life, and this royal collection continued to grow up into the reign of Queen Victoria 300 years later in the mid-19th to early 20th century. Many times, these portraits were objects utilized in political relationships or arranged marriages, as in the case of the veiled marriage of Henry VIII and Anne of Cleves. Hans Holbein the Younger painted a portrait of Anne, in his mind accurately displaying her beauty. The portrait had been sent along with many other portraits of eligible women to aid the king's decision to choose his fourth wife. Henry VIII was not so impressed with Holbein's interpretation. When Anne arrived, Henry VIII declared that she was so ugly he could not consummate the marriage. Many times, miniatures were also remembered to use lost loved ones. For instance, Queen Victoria commissioned paintings of her children and in memoriam for her husband, Prince Albert, after he had died. These pieces are all part of the royal collection held by the current Queen Elizabeth II. Although miniatures are a form of painting, they are not created in the same way that full-scale portraits are. As they are done on a smaller scale, they require different techniques and materials. Early miniatures were painted in watercolor on vellum, a dried animal skin, often with a playing card as backing to strengthen the material. As the technique improved and styles changed, miniatures were also painted on small slices of ivory or enamel. Ivory, though an expensive material, was more stable and less pliable for miniatures as to reduce the chance of bending, breaking, or cracking of the miniature. However, it was still a very fragile material. So what do you do with these miniatures? Portrait miniatures were commonly worn as jewelry around the neck, wrist, or sometimes as rings, allowing the commissioner of the piece to hold them close. The necklace style miniature were often fashioned as lockets, hiding the subject from public view. Miniatures were often round or oval in shape, although they could also be rectangular. Miniatures that were meant to be worn were frequently decorated with lavish jewels and precious metals. This made them more valuable and costly to create. Many also had small chambers, either secretive or clearly visible, to display decorative designs, which incorporated the hair of the sitter to make them even more personal. I think that this is a little bit creepy. Another form of miniatures were eye miniatures, another creepy form of miniatures, which are small artworks which represent only the sitter's eye, often worn as a pin or a ring. These small miniatures were often used in illicit love affairs, as it is almost impossible to recognize someone just from one eye. One of the pieces in the JCMA collection that interested me is titled Mrs. Siddons, and is identified as being after Gainsborough. Thomas Gainsborough was a highly regarded portrait and landscape artist of the 18th century in England, whose specialty was full-length portraits of high-born English aristocrats. Gainsborough's career began around 1745, when he opened his own studio in Holborn, London. During the 1750s, when Gainsborough began to have immense financial difficulties, he moved back. It was here that his work began. tried to use the Flemish master as a model for his portraits. Of all of the old masters, Gainsborough wanted to focus on Van Dyck because of his history with England. He painted for James I, then left to go and study and paint in Italy, and then returned to paint for Charles I. He was welcomed back to England with much pomp and circumstance due to his popularity. Gainsborough painted many wealthy women and their husbands, and these commissions helped with his financial problems. Gainsborough's wealthy patrons also allowed him to study their private collection, many of which contained works by Van Dyck. Eventually, Gainsborough earned enough money to return to London, where he would paint his most famous and prestigious paintings. Before returning to London, however, Gainsborough began entering paintings to the public exhibition at the Society of Artists in London. He was invited to do so because he was recognized for his style of Van Dyck portraiture. When Joshua Reynolds, another prominent painter of the time, became president of the Royal Academy in 1768, he invited Gainsborough to join as a founding member. According to Niccolo Kalinske in his biography of the artist, Gainsborough did not find appeal in the bureaucracy of the group and had a major falling out with them in 1773. He did not send any work to the exhibition again until 4 years later in 1777. Although he was a founder of the Royal Academy, Gainsborough never attended a meeting of the group, had very few influential friends, and thus struggled in London. By the end of his lifetime, Gainsborough had created more than 700 portraits, even though these were by no means his favorite type of painting. Some of Gainsborough's most famous sitters include King George III and his wife, Queen Charlotte, as well as many fine ladies, including the actress Mrs. Sarah Siddons, Mrs. Thomas Graham, Mrs. Sheffield, Mrs. Sheridan, and noble women like Georgiana, the Duchess of Devonshire. The JCMA miniature, Mrs. Siddons. Mrs. Siddons was a leading actress in the Drury Lane Theater and was a common subject for both Gainsborough and Joshua Reynolds, who painted the single most famous painting of her. She was a celebrity of her time, known for her triumphs on the stage as a dramatic actress. If she were an actress today, Mrs. Siddons would rival Meryl Streep in both popularity and ability as a dramatic actress. In portraits, Mrs. Siddons is typically depicted with an extremely large nose, about which Gainsborough reportedly said, "Damn the nose, there's no end to it." As you can see, our portrait miniature bears no resemblance to Gainsborough's Mrs. Siddons portrait. The nose is not prominent in the miniature. The clothing in the full-length portrait is also very different. There are differences in color, design, and style. The biggest discrepancy is the positioning of the sitter. In the full-length portrait, the sitter is seated in a chair, providing an almost full profile view. In the miniature, the sitter is standing, leaning against a classical column in a three-quarters profile. Although these differences do not definitively prove that they are different women, I found another painting which resembled the JCMA miniature more distinctly. Gainsborough's The Honorable Mrs. Graham looked far more like our miniature than Mrs. Siddons. Mrs. Graham also happens to be one of the first paintings that Gainsborough submitted to the Royal Academy in 1777, marking his grand return to the London artistic sphere. Mary Graham posed for the painting a year after she married a wealthy Scotsman by the name of Thomas Graham. Art historian Lord Ronald Sutherland Gower recounts an interesting story about Mrs. Graham. Quote, "She died when only 35 after a marriage of such unclouded happiness that her heartbroken husband could not bear to look upon Gainsborough's lifelike portrait of her as a bride." So our next question has to do with attribution. Is our miniature by Gainsborough or a follower of him? Could this even just be a copy by other artists? Without traveling back in time and watching the artist create the piece, or without finding documents that trace the object's full provenance back to Gainsborough, we cannot be sure. But there are some things we can look for to make an educated guess. One of the first things I did was look to see if Gainsborough created any other miniatures. He is well known for full-length portraits, so I thought it would not be surprising to find some miniatures among his 700 portraits. However, I only found one miniature by Gainsborough, a self-portrait which sold at auction in August of 2011. The self-portrait originally was purchased for £800 on a hunch, as the art historian thought that it might be by Gainsborough. Once he acquired the miniature, he noticed an inscription on the back, Gainsborough. If authenticated, it could be worth £100,000. Unfortunately, other than this example, I have found no other miniature by Gainsborough. He seems to have specialized almost exclusively in full-length portraits. Although it's unlikely our miniature is by Gainsborough, if one does a simple eBay search for the Honorable Mrs. Graham, you find a few miniatures of various quality that represent the JCMA portrait. The Victoria and Albert Museum in London holds at least one miniature after Gainsborough with the subject of Mrs. Graham. Unlike the JCMA piece, the Victorian Albert's painting is attributed to a specific artist, Daniel MacLeese. Similar to the JCMA piece, it was created in the early to mid-19th century. There were also a few other miniatures on various auction websites. Many of these pieces are more impressionist in style and have a more open interpretation of the original piece. Often the color is different in the clothing and hair. The level of detail is also different between different versions of the paintings. Some almost look unfinished. So what does all of this mean? Over the past few months, I feel that Mrs. Graham, as I am apt to call her, has become almost a friend. From a miniature whose provenance seemed undoubtful to completely reworking the attribution, Mrs. Graham has proven to be so interesting, exposing me to far more in the art world than I could have imagined. She may have been erroneously labeled as another fine lady, but henceforth we can give her the proper credibility by labeling her Mrs. Graham in the museum.